Say it ain't so. It appears that Death Stranding will not remain exclusive to the PlayStation consoles. Let's get into it. What's up, peoples? It's your boy MM2K back again with another one. Hey, yo, before we get too deep into this one, can you do your boy a huge favor as always? Can you hit that like button? Can you hit that subscribe button if you haven't already? And rock those bells for notifications so you know when I'm dropping these doses. Hey, look, I appreciate all of y'all straight up, because you know what? I'm not too proud to ask. All right, let's get into it. Okay, in a previous video, I had referred to my homeboy Nibble, and I'm probably saying that wrong, aka Nibellion out there on Twitter, all right? Now, here's what Nibellion had wrote in my last video that adds a little bit of credence to this one. Nibellion had wrote about Death Stranding's release date going to be November 8th, 2019. Come to find out, Jason Schreier of Kotaku had echoed that sentiment, had added to that he found out that Last of Us 2 was supposed to release as well in 2019, but that may have got pushed back to February of 2020. Now today what we have is we got another tweet again from my boy Nibellion that says, quote, same guy who has leaked the November 8th release date, meaning the Antonio Fusito individual from Italy, the news reporter, he says the same guy who released that information also has said that Death Stranding is a PS4 time exclusive, will come to PC at a later date. So that sent the Twitter sphere buzzing and at a blaze. A lot of people said, hold on, there is no information about that. And until we get something from Sony or Kojima about that, you know what? It's just fake news. Then Timur Hussein, a global news head for GameSpot.com, had added to that tweet or responded to it. He said, they already said this publicly, referring to a 2015 Kojima and Andrew House interview with GameSpot about the upcoming game. All right, so let's refer to that and put everything out on the table so we know where we're at as far as this game and what is this exclusive to and what it's not exclusive to. That 2015 article was actually written by Timur, and it reads, Kojima's PlayStation 4 console exclusive will come to PC. Sony says Konami will remain a valuable partner going forward. It continues to read, Sony Computer Entertainment further discussed its partnership with Hideo Kojima's new independent studio, now known as Kojima Productions, in some of the terms of its PlayStation 4 exclusive project. In a press release issued by SCE President and Global Chief Andrew House at the time, said Kojima is a big part of PlayStation's history and therefore is delighted that he has chosen to bring his brand new project to life in partnership with PlayStation. The article further reads, in a Q&A issued by the company, it was revealed that Sony is not investing in Kojima Productions, and the unnamed game in question is planned to become available on PC after its PlayStation 4 release. Wow! Now, what does your boy MM2K got to say about all this? Simply put, like I always tell y'all, y'all can't keep fighting this console war because the console war is over. Microsoft put down its flag way back in 2016, 2017. Sony effectively accepted that flag in 2019 when they went into the exploratory memorandum to do business as far as the Azure servers and future of cloud gaming. Therefore, the console war has ended. Now, I get it. There's going to be a lot of fanboys battling back and forth, and there may be a little jabs here and there competitively between the two companies, but nothing as serious as it was before. So that's a different thing. That is the fanboy war. But the console war is effectively over. These companies are looking at ecosystems and reaching as many gamers as they can. And Kojima and his own studio is looking to do that. We don't even know if Sony's going to publish this game on PC. So this is a Kojima thing. So to think that people now want to be limited to console going into the future is a farce. There are a potential of 200 billion gamers when you add up all of the other realms of gaming, PC, mobile, all that other stuff. These companies, whether it's the console makers or the publishers, are trying to reach them, like it or not. You know what I'm saying? That's the business strategy. Now, you can divert them from that business strategy if you speak up enough, if you don't like it. But again, trying to deny it is not being based within reality. And that's it from your boy MM2K. Let me know what you think about what I had to say in the comment section below. Like I always tell y'all, y'all can come with me and come at me. It don't matter to your boy. But if you did like what you had to hear, click on the links below to follow me. You can catch me on the corner of every boulevard. You know what I'm saying? Hey, yo, I do a show with your peoples. Neethles, Dirk Griggity, Snow Bunnies, Call Scram Punks. We do it every Wednesday, 9:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Check out Dirk Griggity's channel where we air it, or hashtag Scram Punks anywhere to find out more details. And last but not least, check out my brethren, the Broadband Bullies. We doing a damn thing. Check out that Discord link. Yo, support us on that Patreon link. Check out that gear is fly. And as always, you have a wonderful gaming day.